addition to honoring our seniors, we're going to celebrate our 8th grade students' graduation from middle school. These students spent the last month of school in a May term class called Passages. And this course has become a school tradition where we recognize and ritualize the transition from middle school to high school.
So during 8th grade Passages, our students grappled with a few essential questions. Those questions were, what is sacred? What does it mean to live a life of privilege? What does it mean to be of service? And what does it mean to walk well in the world? And we explored these questions through the study of Native cultures and Native people, and through a week-long service project to the Pine Ridge Reservation in South Dakota. So we wanted to share some of the things we noticed about this class during our trip to Pine Ridge. We give you guys a little bit of framing for what they accomplished. During our service project, these students spent long days building a house for a struggling family on the reservation. They put up walls and cut firewood for the winter. And over the course of these days, they learned to find joy in even the most tedious of tasks. Our students also participated in a sweat lodge, or a nipi, which is a traditional Lakota ceremony. And in the sweat, they learned to respect elders. They learned respect for other cultures. And they also were sitting in a hot, dark lodge and learned a lot of tolerance for adversity.
Additionally, something they did was work to understand another culture. We were both impressed with their ability to build relationships out of curiosity, where they bridged the gap between cultures and between socioeconomic status. They took the time to meet with people, to talk with people, and to develop genuine relationships. Additionally, they had a solo experience where they removed themselves from distractions that can come from technology and their social lives, simply to be by themselves with no distractions. And one of the things they were looking at is, what's the difference between being alone and being lonely? And can you find comfort in the company you keep when it's just you?
So we'd like to introduce the 8th grade graduation speakers. These two young women were elected by their peers to speak. We had the class vote, and they received landslide vote to speak as a team. So we'd love to welcome Maya and Tessa up to the stage.
So one night at Pine Ridge Reservation, the 8th grade was huddled together during a council session. During the council session, we had a Native woman named Waylon Jones. Our guided question in council was, who inspires you? The students talked about their grandparents, idols, parents. We all have some people that inspire us in our daily lives. Waylon thought about it differently. He told us a story his grandmother told him, because when he was little, he was smaller than everyone else, and people thought he was not strong or tough. This is the story he told us. A long time ago, there were only animals. They lived among each other, but one day, they began to have jealousy between each other. To solve the problem, the higher spirit put a black cloth across the sky to make there have no daylight for the animals. The biggest bird in the group, the eagle, said, "I can pull the cloth down from the sky." He flew up to the sky, but before he got to the sky, he fell to his death. The owl said, "I can pull the sheep down from the sky." Same thing happened. The owl only got so far and fell to his death. However, this little tiny hummingbird said, "I can try." Every animal laughed and laughed. "You're so tiny, you can't get up there. You're just a hummingbird." The hummingbird didn't let that bother him. He believed in himself. He took flight and poked little holes into the cloth to make the stars, so at night the animals could see. The higher spirit pulled the cloth down from the sky and told the animals that further they figured, he would put it up for the second half of the day of every day. The 8th grade is the hummingbird. You're little but powerful, and you're able to accomplish anything you set our minds to.
During this year, our class had a lot of difficulties with collaboration. We all wanted our ideas to be the best, and we got everything. I mean, everything. We started to get better at the beginning of May term when we were forced to fix the problem. The first thing Chris and Emily made us do was walk from Watershed to the top of Mount St. Edith, and it was snowing. Struggling together made us work better as a team. When we really started to put up with each other was when we had to spend 7 days together. 7 days is not a long time, but you don't realize how well you get to know someone in that short time. We have really bonded and found each other's strengths and weaknesses. Looking back on it, I think we had a hard time because we were all so different. But then we used those differences to help us work together. The shared experience also gave us a new view on each other. Going to Pine Ridge was a struggle. With hammers, nails, and 2x4s, we built a frame of a house for a 5-person family packed in a small trailer. We experienced a huge sweat lodge. During the ceremony, we sat in a small willow frame structure covered in blankets, where there were fire-heated rocks that an elder poured water on. When the door closed, it was so dark you couldn't see your hand in front of your face. You got, like, really terrified. Even though we were still in the U.S., we were in a place that none of us had even been close to experiencing. Being away from our phones and our world, we started to live more in the moment. We met people that value time in a different way than we do as privileged Americans. They don't plan out every second of the day on the calendar on their phones. They just let the day happen. We saw things in a different light. Like, it was like nothing else mattered than the thing we were doing in that moment, which made service work go a lot faster than we expected. We realized that living in the moment is not just being present, but it's connecting with the people and environment around you. So there are a couple people the 8th grade have connected with this year as a whole. So thank you, parents, for supporting us through everything. I mean, everything. Being a teenager is not fun sometimes, lots of emotions, and thank you for being here for us and not giving up on us. Thank you, Emily Graff, you've really connected with us this year in a way that we really appreciate. You have made this 8th grade transition from a bumpy ride to a nice, smooth path. You've especially connected with the 8th grade girls. We love talking to you about our problems. Thank you, Chris, you're a phenomenal art teacher. We have learned so much from you this year, and your sense of humor is off the charts. During May term, we cannot stop talking about your hilarious jokes. We also appreciate your dedication and passion to your students. Thank you, Jen. We love how you connected with us from a teacher's perspective and also from a student's perspective. You've really made this 8th grade year a year to celebrate. Personally, I have never done so much work that is connected to myself as an individual. We love your passion for helping us through these years of struggle. Thank you, Hannah, for being a teacher that understands us. You have pushed us this year in a way that will make us succeed in the future. Some of us didn't appreciate science as much as we do now, and thank you for that. Science has always been cool, but it's way cooler when you have a teacher that has a huge passion for it. Thank you for being an amazing advisor to Ben, Soren, Sila, and I. Thank you, Wayland, and his family for being someone that we all connected with and will never forget. We are still talking about with his stories that he has shared with us. Thank you, Wayland, for being such an inspiring person to be around. Meeting Wayland and his family has been life-changing. 8th grade class of 2018. Thank you for being a group of happiness. You guys are the light in the darkness. Thank you for being yourself and not trying to be someone else. You are all so unique, and it makes a class have a lot of meaning and depth within it. We love you guys.
This is exciting, but also scary. Many of us are leaving Watershed for high school, but that doesn't mean we won't cross paths someday. We have bumpy road ahead of us. We have come so far in 14 years. Imagine how far we have gotten by the time we're 28. Who knows? Let our next adventure begin.
Thank you, Tessa and Maya. We are now going to welcome Watershed's graduating 8th grade class to the stage. Come on up. Alright, we decided for this year's 8th grade graduation that we would bring a Watershed tradition into this ceremony, which is something that we do almost daily at Watershed, which is to express gratitude. And it's one of the character traits that we see as a skill. The more you practice it, the better you get at it. And so on this course, we practice a lot of gratitude when we're at Pine Ridge. We practice gratitude with Lakota people. And so Emily and I are going to express our gratitude towards these students that made this a wonderful month together. Before we do that, we shared this at the passage ceremony. We're up here, we get some kind of credit for these guys, but really we put in a month of work. It's really the middle school educators, Jeff and Eva and Janie and Hannah and Jen, who have put in the lion's share of work. So we'd like to kick it off with a huge round of applause for those middle school educators. and Cinder, and myself. No. Okay, so we're gonna go alphabetical order. Remember, when we say your name, just step forward so everybody can see you, and we have some appreciations. Sarah, we appreciate your calm and consistent demeanor, but also your willingness to openly communicate your thoughts to help us all better understand a reading or how we might improve as a group. You stand your ground when it comes to your values, but also listen attentively to others, and that is something to hold on to. Thank you. Tessa, thank you for your maturity and patience as a student and a community member. Whether you were writing poetry, doing service work, getting feedback on your graduation speech, or hiking Mount Sanitas, you did it gracefully, and that you remained open and are consistent in your effort. Thank you.
Violet, we are so grateful for the genuine care you show for your friends, classmates, and teachers. You go out of your way to check in with individuals. In your self-awareness, you show grace and maturity. On Pine Ridge, in the midst of days defined by hard physical work, you made sure to check in with your peers on how they were doing emotionally. And thank you for all the help. Thank you for your sense of humor. At times irreverent, you always managed to bring lightheartedness and fun to our long work days. In Sweat Lodge, we saw you show grit in pushing through your discomfort and learning to accept adversity.
Ben, we want to appreciate you for the unbelievable work ethic that you displayed at Pine Ridge. Whether it was stacking firewood, framing walls for a new house, doing demolition, or running loads of trash, you did it with heart and commitment. Additionally, I personally want to thank you for having a first, which was a student doing my laundry and folding it and putting it on my bunk bed. Thank you, Ben.
We want to appreciate you for your passion. It was a joy to see you discover a love for poetry writing during winter, and you took time outside of class to perfect your work. As a leader of the day on our hike up Mount Sanitas, you threw yourself into learning about group management and made compassionate decisions for the group. Thank you for your drive to learn.
Porter, we want to appreciate you for your calm and steady and honest way of being. You sprained your ankle early on and then had to hike in the Badlands, as well as doing hours of service in a boot, and you always took it in stride. Your easygoing nature and comfort with yourself clearly rubbed off on the rest of us. Thank you.
Ethan. A few words that others used to describe our group on Pine Ridge included energetic, bouncy, unstoppable, and literally insane. At the end of the week, we learned that our group had worked longer and harder days than most that visit the res. Ethan, you were always at the forefront of this energy. We appreciate you for stepping into a leadership role on our service projects. You were a leader among your peers, whether it was teaching people how to hit a nail correctly or how to find joy in hard work. Thank you.
Kinsey, we want to appreciate you for your truly relentless curiosity that ranges from innocent questions to the highly complex ones that reveal the degree to which you are critically thinking about the world around you. Thank you for being so engaged no matter what we were doing. Thanks, Kinsey.
Soren, in the weeks leading up to Passages, Soren asked me repeatedly, are we going to be writing poetry on May term? We were thrilled to see this anticipation turn into a commitment to your creativity. We want to appreciate your curiosity about Native people and your drive to translate that curiosity into art. You are fearless in forging connections with others, especially those who are very different from yourself. We are inspired by your open-hearted approach to the world around you. Thomas, we want to appreciate you for your humility and commitment to nature. Without telling anyone about it, you wrote a beautiful and original poem about Pine Ridge that demonstrated your close observation of Native culture and your surroundings. Thank you for your quiet confidence.
Hi. Ty, I want to personally appreciate you for relentlessly inviting me to play basketball and helping me to improve my game. Your love of play and the way you brought people into whatever game was at hand contributed greatly to the overall fun of our time together. Additionally, whether it was with a crowbar or a hammer, you truly seemed to appreciate demo or demolition, even though sometimes you took it a little too far. Nonetheless, you always worked with integrity and heart. Thank you.
On our first night in Pine Ridge, I was sleep deprived and clearly not in the best mood. Within all of the mayhem, Jenna came up to me and said, "How are you doing, Emily?" and gave me a hug. This is just one example of Jenna's unconditional empathy towards others. She goes out of her way to check in with people and lift them up. We are so grateful for your thoughtful and kind presence in our group.
Ryzen, we want to appreciate you for always seeing or finding the need and filling it. Additionally, your sincerity, humor, and groundedness were essential for this group in our time at Pine Ridge. Personally, I want to thank you for my new salute. And lastly, we wanted to say, you put the Zen in Ryzen. Maya, we want to thank you for your nonstop enthusiasm. Whether it was dancing on the deck or marveling at the wonders of Carhartt pants, you bring enthusiasm to everything you do. You brought energy, optimism, and spirit to every aspect of our May term course. You are game, up for whatever, and that's a gift. Thank you for sharing it with us. We'd like to present you with Watershed's graduating eighth grade class.